hundreds of people marched through the streets of Hong Kong, demanding the release of jailed Chinese dissident Liu Xiaobo, ahead of him receiving the Nobel Peace Prize in Norway.
Well, I think it's a shame, but I think the fact that the citizens of Hong Kong can speak out as opposed to the 1.3 billion people in China that are not able to, I think we need to do what we do today.
And when we go to Norway, we will protest outside the Chinese embassy. We will also protest outside the Nobel Peace Prize ceremony, City Hall, and to show our support for Liu Xiaobo, to show our support for Liu Xiaobo to get the award.
But mainland Chinese, whose rights he championed, will not be attending. Amnesty International reports China has jailed hundreds in the run-up to Friday's awards ceremony. The group also reports that Liu's wife, who could have collected the $1.5 million prize for him, is under house arrest. A Chinese foreign ministry spokeswoman said Tuesday that many countries support China in opposing the award for Liu.
More than 100 nations and organizations in the world have clearly presented their support for China's stance to oppose the Nobel Prize Committee this year.
China has mounted a campaign to keep other countries from sending representatives to the ceremony in Oslo. 19 aren't going, including Russia, Serbia, Saudi Arabia, and Iran. Bruce Gilley, a political scientist at Portland State University in Oregon, expects that despite China's campaign against the Nobel Prize, some measure of liberalization is underway there.
I do not believe the Nobel Prize will have any measurable effect on political reform in China, any more than the award of the same prize to His Holiness the Dalai Lama in 1989 had any effect on Chinese rule in Tibet. But I do believe it will serve as an important beacon to policymakers outside of China, reminding them to engage and target and to retain faith in Liu Xiaobo's China.
And this from Thaline Kine of Human Rights Watch.
What the Liu Xiaobo Nobel has created for the Chinese government is a running sore that's going to continue as long as he is imprisoned.
Kine says as long as there is a news story that refers to Liu Xiaobo, the light will be shining on China's human rights practices. Laurel Bowman, VOA News, Washington.